There's the big political news of the day.
I just fundamentally believe if you look at the facts, you look at the numbers, that Ted Cruz is the best positioned by far to both win the nomination of the Republican Party and to then go on and defeat Hillary Clinton.
Well, Walker wants Cruz, so is Ted Cruz the establishment's last hope? Former Virginia Governor George Allen. Well, he was back at Rubio, and now he's sitting on the sidelines kind of watching all of this. George, I know you're not the kind of guy that sits on the sideline long. did this kind of sway you a little bit? And how important was this endorsement for Cruz?
Well, let me have, first of all, hail, Charles. Good to be with you. I was for Marco Rubio. That's the team I was backing. I now look at this as a Giants-Eagles playoff game. So that's about enthusiasm I have for it right now.
As a dyed-in-the-wool Redskins fan, we should let the audience know in case they're not sure.
Right. And ultimately, you get to the Super Bowl, and I was for the Giants against the New England Patriots because I liked Archie Manning's son, Eli. But this endorsement by Governor Walker is big, very big in Wisconsin. He's run so many elections. There's no one there in Wisconsin who knows the state better politically than Scott Walker. And that's going to be very, very helpful to him. And the way I look at it, with all the ads that the Cruz campaign and Cruz PACs and anti-Trump PACs are coming, the cheeseheads will be spinning in Wisconsin with all the ads. And I think this really, for a week to go with Governor Walker's support, this is really big and helpful.
They say politics makes for strange bedfellows. And we've got the Stop Trump crew out there, the establishment out there. Certainly they're no friends of Ted Cruz. Everyone knows, I mean, one of the key issues here has been his likability or lack of likability amongst folks in Washington, D.C. But why have they galvanized, do you think, around him as opposed to perhaps a Kasich or even earlier? I guess they were rallying around Rubio, although there was pressure on Rubio from the establishment to get out even before Florida.
Oh, you're right, Charles. Well, heck, if the so-called establishment had their way, Jeb Bush would be our nominee. Governor Kasich, I think he'll probably do fairly well, but I don't think he'll win in Wisconsin. He's looking at other states. There's a lot of folks that are motivated mostly right now about who they're against, which is unfortunate. I like to be motivated for positive, constructive ideas and someone who can win. And indeed, if you look at the head-to-heads, Marco Rubio, or these days the one who's in, John Kasich, does best head-to-head, and Bernie Sanders does best amongst the Democrats. But that's obviously not a priority factor for voters. They want to send a message, or they're sensing anger or frustration,
right,
or betrayal.
Right.
And so, yeah, I do think the establishment is unifying behind Cruz, and they're running plenty of negative ads and positive ads and everything against Donald Trump.
We'll see.
Donald Trump's waiting for New York. That's where he's going to have his key battle.
And no doubt about it. And, of course, we'll see if the establishment's right this time. George, see you real soon, buddy.
All right. Take care, Charles.
All right,
adios.
Ya.